How many of you are excited to be in the house of the Lord? Say yes. Yes. Hey, do me a favor and elbow your neighbor and say, man, I'm glad I'm sitting by you. Hey, some of you need to chill out. Some of you got a little angry. Some of you guys need to work something out there. You're elbowing too hard. Hey, I'm going to invite everybody to stand to your feet. We're getting ready to enter in a time of worship. Yes. If you are in the lobby, make your way into the tabernacle. It is a good night to be in church. The Bible says is that we are to enter his courts with praise. If you picture this, this is the place that we get to praise God. Yeah. And we don't have to do this, but we get to do this. Some of us, we got to notify our faces, notify our spirits and say, my body isn't in control, but my spirit is in control. I came ready to praise the name of the Lord. Yes. I came ready to receive the word of the Lord. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for what you are getting ready to do. Lord, we lay aside our agenda. Lord, we lay aside our to-do list. And tonight, we enter in and we ask, Lord, that you would show up and show off like only you can. In Jesus' name, we all say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's worship right now.
Put down the donut and pick up the praise. You ready to praise the Lord? Come on, let's praise him together. Put your hands together. Let everything that has breath, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let everything
that has breath,
praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm praising the valley. I praise on the mountain. Hey. I'll praise when I'm sure, and praise when I'm doubting. Yeah, I'll praise when I'm numbered, and praise when surrounded. My praise is the water, my enemies drowning. As long as I'm breathing,
as long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise.
Sing praise.
Praise, Lord, of my soul.
Here we go. I praise when I feel it, and praise when I don't. Oh, I praise 'cause I know God's in control. My praise is a weapon.
My praise is a weapon. It's more than a sound.
My praise is the shout.
My praise is the shout.
Say
that brings Jericho down.
As long as I'm breathing,
as long as
this is our reason. Hey,
I've got a reason to praise.
Father, we praise you tonight.
Oh,
we will praise.
Hallelujah.
Say,
I won't be quiet. I won't be quiet.
Father, we thank you because you are good, you are faithful, you are kind, and that's why we worship you. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Father, we love you, and this is why we praise.
I praise because you're sovereign, praise because you reign, praise because you rose and defeated the grave.
I praise.
I praise because you're faithful.
You are true.
Praise because you're true.
Say.
Praise because there's nobody greater than
I praise.
You. I praise because you're sovereign, praise because you reign, praise because you rose and defeated the grave. I praise because you're faithful, praise because you're true, praise because there's nobody greater than you.
Oh, we love to
praise the Lord, oh my soul.
Everybody praise.
Praise.
Hallelujah. You're worthy of my
Lord,
praise.
Oh my
so
soul.
Worthy of all I praise.
Praise, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh my soul.
I won't be quiet.
I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside?
I won't take.
I won't be
our
quiet.
God is
our
alive.
God is alive.
Oh,
how could I keep it inside?
I won't be quiet.
I
power and the of the honor. Come on, just lift up your voices and give him the fruit of your lips. Father, we love you tonight. You're great and greatly to be praised in the city of our God and in the mountain of his holiness. Hey, come on, clap. We're going to shift our praise tonight. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Say,
now all on my feet, I will turn into praise. Shake off despair as I sing out your name. A victory dance, I will dance loud and big. I will crush disappointment and break marriage.
Now all of my
fears, I will turn into
shake off
despair. Shake off despair as I sing out your name.
A victory
dance, I will dance loud and big.
I will crush disappointment
and break marriage.
Now all of my fears, shake off the spell.
Oh,
a victory dance. I will crush disappointment. Say,
break
every,
break
every chain in Jesus' name.
Shake off despair as I sing out your name. A victory dance, I will dance loud and big. I will crush disappointment and break marriage.
Now all of my
fears, I will turn into praise.
Shake off despair
as I sing out your name.
A victory dance,
I will dance loud and big.
I will crush
disappointment and break marriage.
Receive our praises. Your name is high. If I sing every song, I would need to sing once more to describe you, to define you. My words can never do it justice to tell of all your goodness, but my heart will always
oh. Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you, God, that your banner over us is love. Your word says, God, that it is because of your loving kindness that we are not consumed. Your compassions are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness. Hallelujah. Great is his faithfulness. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised in the city of our God and in the mountain of his holiness. Do I have a praiser in the house tonight that knows that no matter what you face, that God is able to do exceeding and abundantly and above all that you could ask or think? My God, I feel like somebody came in this room for a miracle tonight. Somebody came believing that the supernatural working God is in the building. Hallelujah. Come on, give him one more shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Glory be to his wonderful name. Well, we are here from Valor Christian College, and we are so excited to be worshiping with you tonight. Elkhart, so glad that you're in the house. If you are a first-time guest, a first-time visitor, first time you're a visitor, second time your family. Anytime after that, your family. Right. You are our VIP, our very important person. So there is a connect card in the seat, and at the end of service we want you to fill that card out completely, and at the end of service take it to the back. There's a sign out there that it's a boot. You see a big sign. We want to give you a gift from our pastor and First Family.
Yes. And who's been excited? It's October, outpouring. Let me hear a big shout if you are so excited. We have so many great things coming up for October outpouring. And one of those things being our preacher tonight, Pastor Brian Oswald, who is Audrey's dad. So it makes it even better, even more special. And don't miss out as well. Next week is going to be Pastor Chris Deegan, October 18th. He's coming all the way here to preach. And look, y'all hear him sing all the time, but I promise you, he has such a powerful word.
Yes. And something exciting coming up this coming Sunday is What's Next. It is a 40-minute class telling you the what's and why behind World Harvest Church Elkhart. And at that time, any questions you have will be answered by the campus pastors. And it is coming up this coming Sunday, directly after the 10 a.m. service.
10 p.m. is really late for a service, huh?
Hey.
Well, do we have any dream teamers in the house? Dream team, make some noise. We love our dream team. Dream team is what we call our amazing group of volunteers at World Harvest Church Columbus and Elkhart. Yes. And this Sunday, this coming Sunday night at 5 p.m., you have dream teamers team night. Do not miss it. So dinner is served at 5, promptly at 5. And then Pastor Nate and Miss Carly, they have some information for you going forward with this fall season. And I'm sure that's wonderful things in store. Coming up the rest of the year, how many of you are expecting to have a great year these last 4 months? I don't know about you, but I am. I'm expecting, and I was telling Audrey, my wife, I just feel excited about this. I don't know what's coming up. I feel something about to happen in this holiday season. So be expectant, because I believe that God's going to do great things.
Yes.
And I'm excited for it. Amen?
Amen.
I mean, I'm excited about the turkey and the ham and all the things that's happening. But I'm excited about all the other things too. Amen? Well, if you would stand to your feet, we're going to put 2 minutes on the clock. We're going to have meet and greet. Meet somebody you haven't spoken to in a long time and ask them what is their favorite flavor of pumpkin pie. Go. Go.
Grab your seat. Man, I don't know about you, but we just entered the presence of the Lord. Can anybody say amen? I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you to Sterano, to Audrey, to Aislinn. Thank you all for traveling. I know I brag on Valor all the time, but you guys are amazing, and we thank you, and I am so glad that Pastor Brian and his beautiful wife, Deanne, are here, because we wouldn't get Sterano and Aubrey without them coming. Because, and I was teasing them, I was like, man, that was amazing. And thank you guys for traveling. And you guys are amazing. I pray blessings over your ministry. And I mean, you guys just got married. I think the anointing doubled. Holy cow. But I got to give you a hard time, Sterano. You all may be seated if you're standing. That clip's going on our social media tomorrow. What's your favorite flavor of pumpkin pie? That's going on our, that's our promo for Baskets of Blessing. What kind of pumpkin pie is it gonna be? What flavor do you want? Pumpkin? I don't know. But man, thank you guys. We bless you. We appreciate everything that you guys did. That was, man, just a great worship. I'm still kind of in it, y'all. You know what I'm talking about? I can't talk straight. But now it's time to give our tithes and offerings. Can anybody say amen? During that song, the very first song, we kept saying, we break every chain, and he breaks every chain. And I started seeing a picture of what it looks like to break a chain. If you ever seen a chain break, you know really what it takes is it's tension. It takes something that's stronger than the chain to break it. And I saw, I kid you not, my prophetic vision, I saw chains around our bank accounts, chains around our wallets, chains around our financial blessings. And how many of y'all know every blessing that we have comes from above? I don't care if you won the lottery, you're going to get saved tonight. That's still a blessing from God. Don't go do it tomorrow, but it's still a blessing unto God. If you won the lottery, you better tithe on that. Amen. But I feel like this is for the Elkhart campus, anybody watching online, is that there are chains around our finances and that God is wanting to break every chain. And I literally saw this, is I saw an offering envelope, one of our offering envelopes as a symbol, is that this became a holy sledgehammer, a holy pry bar, breaking the chains off despair in Jesus' name. Something's on this. I know some of you, you're already tuning me out because you hate this part of the service because we're talking about finances. Listen up. If you want God to do something in your finances, y'all know I don't talk like this all the time, but there is something on it tonight that this is for somebody. And everybody look at your neighbor and say, somebody is you. I always love that when somebody comes up to me after service and go, oh man, if Sister So-and-so is here to hear that message. I mean, no, this message is for you. I believe this is that what Serrano said is I am looking forward to greater blessings in this next 4 months than the rest of 2023. And I believe that God is wanting to do something in our finances so that we could be blessed to be a blessing. It's not just a few people in the church that are going to fund the church. It's going to be the entire church that is going to fund the entire church so that we could do more than what we already are doing. So I want everyone to grab an offering envelope. You can put your debit card on there. You can put your cash, your credit card. You can put a check in there, or you're going to give online. The ways to give are behind me. And I want you, if you're giving online, pull out your phone. That is a holy sledgehammer breaking the curse on the finances of the people of Elkhart. No more will we be a people that are saying this is lack. I believe this is a key for this region, that this will be a region that is known as like, man, they once were in poverty, no more. There's provision. There's ideas coming. There's prosperity in this place. Not so that we can sit high and go, oh, look how good we are. No, so that we're blessed so that we can be a blessing. I want to be one of those cups that we get so full, we pour out, and God keeps filling us up. So tonight, this is for everybody. Whether you're a tither or you've never, ever done this before, tonight, we're going to start tithing. Amen? I got a few people. We're going to start tithing. Amen? What does our pastor teach us? Tithe is 10% of your sanctified gross income, and offering is over and above that. So if you have not tithed this week, this is your tithe. If you've already tithed, tonight's your offering. This is a break every chain offering in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you, Lord, for your word. We thank you that you are the chain breaker. And so tonight, we rebuke the devourer off of every single person's finances. We use this as a holy crowbar, a sledgehammer. This is breaking every chain. And we declare, Lord, that the spirit of mammon, the devourer, Lord, the spirit of scarcity would no longer have its way in these people's finances, in this church, and that provision is flowing. Lord, we ask right now that you, Lord, would bless what is about to be given. Use it, Lord. Multiply it. Let this make a big impact right in our own lives, Lord, in our families' lives, here in Elkhart, at our Columbus campus, and around the world, Lord. Bless the giver. In Jesus' name, we all say amen. Amen. Ushers, you may serve the people. Well, I have, and Paul and Sterana, would you mind pulling the podium up or whoever? Yeah, there we go. Thank you all. I have the direct privilege, the distinct privilege of introducing Professor Brian Oswald. I have just met him, but as of on Tuesday, we had a conversation, and I got to be honest with him, is usually our conversations all last about 10 minutes. I'm not a phone guy, but I just kept asking him questions, and he kept asking me questions, and I was like, man, are you my brother? I've always wanted one. I grew up in a house of sisters and a mom and a dad, and I always wanted a brother. Like, I just kept talking and asking him questions. He was born in Kansas City, Missouri. He pastored for 12 years in Flint, Michigan, did an amazing work there. Flint's dear to my heart. I've done a lot of ministry in Flint. And God has used him in this new season, is brought them to the Columbus campus, and now he teaches at Harvest Preparatory School. How many of y'all know we need men of God in our high schools? Amen? When I found that out, I was like, that's exactly who needs their teaching and just instilling values for the next generation. And he's also teaching at Valor Christian College. So, World Harvest Church Elkhart, please help me welcome to the platform none other than Professor Pastor Brian Oswald.
Thank you all. You can be seated. I just told Campus Pastor Nate. That was the very best introduction I've ever got in my life. So praise God for that. Amen. I hope that we can live up to that tonight, because that was quite the introduction. You know, I'm so thankful tonight to be here. And as we start here tonight, first and foremost, I just want to thank God for our pastor, Pastor Rod Parsley. Can we just give him an honor that he's due tonight and thank him for the vision that includes all of us tonight, a vision that includes Elkhart and Columbus and the whole world. And we thank God for the vision of Pastor Parsley tonight. Bless you, Pastor Parsley. Amen. I'm just thankful tonight for Pastor Parsley. I'm thankful for his family. I'm thankful tonight for the wonderful leaders and elders that we have on our campuses. I'm thankful tonight for Elder Bill Canfield, who is a personal friend, and I love Elder Canfield. And we have a premier team of elders that lead World Harvest Church, and I'm thankful for them. I'm thankful that I got to know Pastor Nate. He's the very best campus pastor you'll ever find anywhere. Amen. The very best. So tonight, as we start, I also am thankful that I have my family with me, Deanne and Preston and Audrey. Where's Audrey? Oh, there she is. Okay. I was like, where did she go? Oh, so Audrey is with me tonight. Sterano just became my son in August, but I tell you that the day he became my son, I told it at their wedding. The day he became my son was the day on a Valor Chapel, he was rolling around on the floor in the Holy Spirit. I was like, that's the day, that's my son right there. So I'm thankful for them tonight. Then all the way from Flint, my mother-in-law and my sister-in-law drove here tonight to be with us, as well as my niece and my nephews. So I'm thankful that they're here with us tonight. Amen. So I'm praising God together with you tonight, because I'm thankful for an October outpouring. Amen. That when I heard that it was going to be an October outpouring, I'm believing God for him to do a wonderful work in our place tonight, right here. I believe it starts right here in our hearts. Faith is stirred, and we're going to see God just work in amazing ways tonight. Amen. Amen. We're going to believe it. Give God praise if you know that he's going to work in your life tonight. So the power of God is what we're going to talk about. I'm going to talk about the October outpouring. I'm going to talk about outpouring of miracles, outpouring of healings, and outpouring of deliverances tonight. You know, when we talk about deliverances, I think about David. David was delivered. David was delivered from his Goliath. He went as a young man, and he went to the giant, and he was hearing the giant defame God. And he said, well, I can't stand for that. So he says, you're coming to me with your spear and sword, but I'm coming to you in the name of the Lord. And what did he do? He put that stone in his sling. And when he slung that sling, God and the power of the Holy Spirit directed it to his giant and brought him down. And God brought deliverance to those people. That's not the only time God brought deliverance to David. God brought deliverance to David, not only when he was facing a giant, he brought deliverance to David when he was also doing this. Saul, King Saul was chasing him, gonna kill him, but God brought him deliverance. Not only did God bring him deliverance from his Goliath and from his King Saul, he brought him deliverance from enemy kings. He went to an enemy king, and what happened? All of a sudden, he changed his nature, and he started acting like he was an insane man, right? And so God delivered him because the king's like, get him out of here. And so God delivered him again. Then we see God delivering him again in rebellion when there was uprisings of his own family. God brought deliverance and resolution to it. See, God's a God that is a continuous deliverer in your life. And he just doesn't deliver you one time. God will deliver you through your entire life. So there's just not one thing that you can say, God, if you can only deliver me from this. God's saying, I'm eager to work in your life tonight in any area and in every area of your life. God can do it tonight. And you know what? A lot of times we as people, we limit God. We limit God. And this is where my scripture is going to start tonight, from Psalm 78, verse 41. It says this, they turned their back, Israel, they turned their back and they tempted God and they limited the Holy One of Israel. When they limited the Holy One of Israel, when you look at the verse and you look at the context and you look into the history of what this word means, it means that it comes from a root word, marked or wound. And so when you limit God, when Israel limited God, they literally caused God pain. And you know, our pastor teaches us that we've got to remove limits in our life. Our pastor teaches us that if we will have faith in God, he can move mighty mountains. If our pastor teaches us that when we live by faith, we take limits off God and we see God do wonders that we can't even exclaim and proclaim tonight. That's what our pastor teaches us. And so when we understand the power and saying, when I have words, when I in my mouth can cause God to be wounded and limited by what I say, we live in doubt and unbelief when that happens. Doubt and unbelief. When we say something like, well, that will never happen for me. I'm glad so-and-so did it, but I'll never get that. You know what that is? That's doubt and unbelief. That's marking God. That's limiting God. That's boxing God. That's God saying you can do it for somebody, but you can't do it for everybody. And God's saying tonight that if you will unbox him, if you take the limits off of him, there's gonna come an outpouring into your life that you've never seen, and it's not just gonna last for one night tonight. It's gonna last all the days of your life, amen? Amen, so I'm thankful tonight that we serve a God who is able to do exceedingly abundantly. Charles Spurgeon said in his sermon on limiting God, he said, man is always altering what God's ordained. You know, man always seems to be the one to never agree with God. God has an amazing ability to do all kinds of things. God has an amazing ability to pour out from glory, and he's able to touch you, and he's able to give you favor, and he's able to bless you, that will bless you and your children's children's blessing. That's the kind of blessing God's able to bestow on you. But when we say, God, I just can't believe that you can do that. Well, you can't ever receive because we don't ever believe. And when we open up our spirit and say, God, I believe that whatever you say is your promise, a pastor teaches us that it's just yes, because all the promises of God in Jesus are yes tonight. And so if you want to see an outpouring in your life, just say yes to him. Just say yes to him. If you need your family saved, just say, yes, Lord, I receive it tonight. If you need a healing in your body, just say, yes, Lord, I receive it tonight. If you need to be delivered from your enemy, if you need to be delivered from captivity, if you need a stronghold broken in your life, just say, yes, Lord, I believe it and I receive it in Jesus' name. Oh, you know, tonight I want to just give you an exhortation, because God's faithfulness is always a testimony to the miracle-working power of God. And the testimony of Jesus, the spirit of prophecy. And so tonight, as you receive prophecy, as you receive encouragement, as you receive these words, I want you to just take heart and be encouraged that there's no weapon that's formed against you that shall prosper, and every word that rises against you, God will condemn, for it is the promise and the heritage of the children of the Lord tonight. And so when that enemy tries to come in at you like a flood, there's going to be a standard that's going to be lifted up. Jehovah Nissi, our banner, is going to shine over us and protect us, because he's in front of me and behind me. He's beside me. He's all the way around me tonight. I thank him tonight. And so when we praise, we say, thank you, Lord. You're encircling me tonight, and you're keeping me in a wonderful way. You're pouring out from glory that. So I'm thankful tonight that Jesus is our wonder working Jesus. I'm thankful that God is a wonder and he does miracles so great. And the testimony I want to share, I want to introduce you to my son. Sometimes you see him, he's swinging his servant towel on the campus when Pastor Chris is giving a praise break and encouraging us, exhorting us. When Strano's up giving exhortation, he's up there slinging his towel. And he says, Dad, I want to run. And he said, you want to run? Go ahead and run. Because what God did for him is a miracle that I want to share with you for just a moment. Because it started in 2013. In 2013, Preston was sick. You know, we took him to the doctor. They said, oh, he has the flu. He'd get better on a Friday. He said, by Monday, the kid should be better. Well, he's like the person in the Bible. He never got better. He grew worse. And Sunday morning, Deanne and me, we talked and we said, look at this boy. This is something just not right. And so we took him to a children's hospital there in Flint. And that's one of the very best children's hospitals in Michigan. And so we took him to the Hurley Children's Medical Hospital, and there they just took the boy. He was really unconscious at that point, and he wasn't responsive. And he was in a DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis coma, and they worked on him again and told us. They said, you need to prepare. His pH balance was off so much. He said, I've never seen it brought back from that point. And right at that moment, I looked at, his name was Dr. Sharman, excellent doctor. And I said, can we just pray together? Can we just pray? And so in the room right there, me, Deanne, Dr. Sharman, we just prayed together. And then we just told him to do whatever he needed to do. Do your work the best he can. He's not going to give up. He said, he's going to do it. Well, on the Tuesday morning, they had a pediatric neurologist come, and they did a scan on Preston, and he had no brain function on a Tuesday morning. And when they were there telling Deanne that he had no brain function, I was at my church at the time, and I was praying with a couple of our men in the church over a prayer cloth, and we were praying for God to work a miracle. And we took that prayer cloth up there to the hospital. I had no idea what, I knew that the neurologist was going to come and run the test, but I had no idea what the outcome was going to be. And when we got there, Dan told me what the doctor told him. And so we took this prayer cloth and we just laid it on his head. And you know, you can't really know how to pray with words. Your vocabulary doesn't really know how to pray during something like that. And so you know what we did? We prayed in the Holy Ghost. That's what we did. And we laid our hands on that prayer cloth and laid that hand on his head, and we prayed in tongues. We actually cried in tongues. And as we were praying and crying in the Holy Spirit, we saw Preston with that prayer cloth on his head. Because there's an anointing that flows through God's tangible anointing. And so when we were having a prayer of agreement, which God says to us in 2023, the pastor says this is a year of essential agreement. And what happened in 2013 already validates it. So when he says that to me, my spirit quickens because I understand the power of agreeing. And so when we agreed in prayer, not only me and Deanne, but me and my family and everybody I could talk to. All over, wherever I could get somebody, I'd ask prayer. So we have people agreeing with us in prayer. And when you have people agreeing together, Matthew 18 says, when two of you agree is touching anything, anything that is requested, God says he can do it. Because with God, there is nothing impossible to them that believe. Nothing impossible. He's able to do it. So we have that prayer cloth on his head, and we're there, and the nurses and doctors leaving us alone because we look like we're radicals to these people. But it's what you have to do. When there is no hope, there is always hope that Jesus is going to come through. We have hope that is an anchor to our soul tonight, the Bible says. And it's Jesus, and he holds you in the darkest moments of your life. He got you. And he's just saying, why is this happening? It's so God can get some glory in it. And so right there, we have that prayer cloth on Preston's head. We're praying for him. Then we see the notice on Tuesday. He went to the hospital on Sunday. We prayed with the doctor on Sunday afternoon. On Tuesday morning, they told us the boy has no neurological function. He's not going to die, but now he's not going to live past being in a vegetative state. And I told Dean at the moment, we said, whatever we have to do, we're going to help take care of this because he's our boy. You know, he's my son. He's our kid. So whatever it has to be, but we're going to believe God, that God's going to do something in his life. And as we laid that prayer cloth on his head, we were praying over in the corner in the where the seating area is. And as we're sitting there praying, all of a sudden there's movement from Preston. Movement. Preston woke up, he ripped the feeding tube right out of his nose, and he told us he was hungry. He told us he was hungry. And so we were able to see God pour out upon our family. A miracle. A miracle. Not because we're somebody important, but because we're his child. And because he cares for us, just like he cares for you. And so Preston, a boy that's supposed to be in a vegetative state, who's never supposed to be here. He has a condition called type 1 diabetes. And on August 20th, 2023, during a praise break, Pastor Chris was having there at the church, Preston takes off and runs. He said, Dad, I want to run. I said, run. Pastor sees Audrey go running behind him. And he goes, what just happened? He just felt a work of God. And he brought Preston up and laid his hand on him and said, watch the diabetes go. Type 1 diabetes, it means that there's going to be a restoration of organ function in him. Type 2 diabetes is other conditions that we're more familiar with. That's the malady of sugar diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is something where you have organ not working, organ failure. And so it's a different type of diabetes. And he laid his hands on him and said, watch the malady go. He said, go. And when he did that, the report that Audrey gave me was that as he was praying for Preston, because always the pastor teaches us that he's not just praying to him, he's praying and talking through them to you, right? And so Audrey told me yesterday when I was having dinner with him, Audrey baked delicious chicken and I was eating it over there, and she goes, guess what, Dad? I said, what? He said, when Pastor prayed for Preston, my friend who goes to Valor, the School of Revival, which I'm thankful that I'm coming up and being a professor out here. I'm thankful tonight that I'm part of Valor, I'm part of Harvest Preparatory School, and I'm part of World Harvest Church. And she goes, guess what, Dad? My friend told me that when Pastor prayed for Preston, she goes, she was a diabetic as well. And she goes, she went to the doctor, and she's not even taking any more of her medicine. She's no longer a diabetic. How about that? He prayed through Preston to Audrey's friend. God is a wonder-working God who pours out miracles. And so what he's doing for us in this end-time season is he's saying, I'm preparing for you. I'm preparing for you. If you will not limit God, I will prepare for you the ability to receive. God used the Apostle Paul's handkerchiefs, and he did extraordinary miracles with them. And so that's tonight what I'm seeing. I'm seeing Jesus in healing. What did he do? He healed the man at the pool of Bethesda. He goes to the pool of Bethesda in John chapter 5, and he's looking for a man that needs, he spies here this man. 38 years he's been sick. 38 years he's been unable to walk. He'd been unable to get into the pool because at certain seasons, the angel would come down and trouble the waters. And the first person that got into the water would be healed of the disease or infirmity. And Jesus goes through the crowd over all these porches and comes to this one man. And he says, do you want to be whole? Do you want to be well? And the man goes immediately. Verse 7, the sick man said, sir, I have no one to put me into the pool when the water stirred. But while I'm coming, another steps down before me. And you know what I feel about this scripture, brothers, sisters? I feel this in my spirit. I feel that this is a particularly important verse for us because we're just like this man. The healer, Jehovah Rapha, he's standing right in front of us asking us, do we want to be well? And you know what we're doing? We're looking at this pool and we're saying, this is how I get well, and I can never get well. Can never do it. And Jesus is just saying, do you want to be well? And this man, he's just saying, I try to get somebody to get me down there. I look at the pool, the angel stirs it. I try to get in, somebody beats me to it. You know, he had faith and hope after maybe the first time, second time. 38 years later, here he still is in the same condition. But Jesus is saying, stop looking at the pool. Stop looking at the pool. Stop looking at your circumstances and thinking this is how you're going to be well. Stop looking at your circumstances and thinking this is how your outpouring is going to happen. Stop looking around you and think this is how I'm going to make it. It says, look to the Lord God, Jehovah Rapha, who is our healer, who heals us from all our diseases. And when he's talking to you about being well, he says, just say yes. So he says, do you want to be well? And he says, yes, yes. And the Lord touched him and he says, rise up, take up your mat and walk. And you know what that man did? He got up, he took his mat, and he started walking. 38 years sick, 38 years lame, 38 years his hope was in the pool. But the time when he put his hope in Jesus, when he says yes to him, all of a sudden his whole world changed. The blind man in John chapter 9 was born blind every day of his life. Every day he went around in darkness, living life as a blind person. Jesus sees him in John chapter 9 and says, be healed, right? He heals him, he touches the man, his sight returns to him. Go wash in that pool, right? So he does this, and then the Pharisees are seeing what's happening. Then all of a sudden, they gather him together and they say, hey, you're the one that was blind, but now you can see, right? He goes, what's your story? You're a sinner, right? He goes, this is what he told me. This is the story he tells the Gospels. He says, this is the only story I know how to share with you tonight. He says, I woke up this morning blind, but I'm going to sleep tonight seeing. And how many people would like to wake up one way and go to bed tonight a different way? Hey, we can do it tonight because Jesus is saying, do you want to be well? Yes. So when we unlimit God, when we take those limits off, God says, watch what I can do. You may have woke up today one way, but you're going to go to sleep a different way tonight. So tonight, I brought with us from the Columbus campus a prayer clause, because I feel in my heart, prayer clause are a connection. It is a point of contact. And tonight our hearts are together as one. And how are we going to connect? And how are we going to see miracles happen? How are you going to see your outpouring come? How are you going to see healing and deliverance and miracles? We're going to hold these prayer cloths. We're going to anoint them, and we're going to agree with you that whatever needs you have, you woke up today with that. It's on your heart. It's on your mind. If it's on your heart and on your mind, it's on God's mind. And he's eager. The testimony of God's faithfulness shows us he's eager. If he did it for me, he'll do it for you. If he did it for Preston, he can do it for you. So every time Preston says he wants to run, we tell him, when it's appropriate, run, boy, run. Because he shouldn't be running. So I thank God for him. And so tonight, what is your need? Do you need a deliverance? Do you need healing? Do you need your family saved? Do you need to see people change your life? Change? See, this is the gospel and the power of the gospel. So tonight, as we close, this is what I like to do. I'd like for us to receive together, each one that will. So if that's everybody, I hope everybody will participate. Because I want to give a prayer cloth to every single person in this room. And I want to agree in faith, Pastor Nate, myself, the ushers, the elders. We're going to agree together that what your need is going to be changed. It's going to be changed. Pastor's been talking about sudden miracles, the tabernacles. He said that you're going to have three distinct miracles by the end of tabernacles. And tonight we're in that tabernacle season. October is an outpouring season. And so as we're in this season, we're just going to believe God that what your miracle is, these prayer cloths are going to be your representation. I have it. I wrote on it. I wrote January 29, 2013, the day God raised up Preston out of the hospital bed. I keep it as a memorial. I keep one prayer cloth in my checkbook where Pastor given us at a prayer cloth service several years ago. It blesses my finances. I put it right there. It never leaves my checkbook. We may never even have checkbooks anymore. I'm still in the age where I know about checkbooks. And so I put it in the checkbook. I don't even use that checkbook, but it's just there as a contact because God's able to do it. And so I keep one in there. I keep them as memorials of what God's going to do in our life. And so tonight, you need a memorial of what God's going to do in your life. Because it's going to be wonderful. You're going to have a testimony. And you're going to be able to share that testimony. And you're going to see people in this community change because of it. So tonight I'm going to ask Pastor Nate to come with me. And I would like everybody to stand, if you would, please. Stand in the sanctuary. I want everyone that will, if you'll come forward, make a line in this altar. We're going to pass out prayer cloths to everyone. So we want everybody to come. Everyone to come. Come and stand. Make a line. We're going to pray together. We're going to believe God to do it. And we're going to just trust that God's going to work in your life. Amen. So maybe the usher can help us because we got prayer cloths all up here. Hallelujah. Let's all come forward, come forward, come up, come up, come up, everyone, so we can have room for everybody. As we go through and give you a prayer cloth, as we agree together, we're just going to know that the power, the outpouring power of God is going to flow, it's going to touch you, and you're going to be changed. Your needs are going to be met. This represents taking the limits off of God. This represents God doing something new like he said he's going to do. Hey, he said he's going to make a way in the wilderness for you. You know, it's hard to walk through jungle paths, but it's easy when God's making a way for you. It's easy to get thirsty in the dry desert arid regions, but when he put oases in the desert places, it's easy to take drink and be filled in those places. And so that's what we're going to do tonight. As we pass this out, we're going to go through, we'll start. And as we go down, we're going to pray and believe. So would you pray in the Spirit with me? Would you pray in the Holy Spirit with me tonight? And as we go and hand you a prayer cloth, it's a representation that God's going to do what he promised to you that he would do, and to not give up hope, not give up faith. But faith is what's going to stir you and keep you, your hope alive and burning on the inside. So God, I thank you tonight that your power is on display in this church tonight. I thank you, God, that the anointing of mighty revivalists are in this place. And God, the same spirit that was in our pastor, in the pastors before, in this house tonight, God. And as our pastor gives these prayer cloths to these members, we pray, God, for you to stir. We pray for the unction to burn. And we pray, God, for miracles, healings, deliverances, God. We thank you, Lord, that the enemy is defeated. And we're surrounded by you in this house tonight. And I thank you that no weapon that's formed against your children are prospering. And every tongue rising against them, you're condemning. And God, we're going to see miracles in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Praise God. Let's go down, brothers and sisters, and let's give each one a prayer clause tonight. Amen. Father, we thank you.
right now, just start praying in the Spirit. Excuse me. Start praying in the Spirit. I want to seal this moment. This is not one of those things that we're not quick to go, but we're going to seal what God has done, that He has healed, He has restored, He has delivered. This is October Outpouring. Let's just seal what God has done right now. If you do not know how to speak in tongues, say, Holy Spirit, baptize me in the Holy Spirit, and then just start moving your lips and start speaking in tongues. Hey, shake it. Right now, if you receive something, I just want you to lift a shout of praise to God. How many of you know when you get a good gift, you say thank you to the gift giver? Let's lift a shout of praise again. Hallelujah! 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 We praise you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Lord, you are great and greatly to be praised. I thank you for the healings, Lord. I thank you for the deliverance, Lord. I thank you for the restoration, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you've done something here tonight, Lord. Seal it in, Lord. Seal it in, Lord. Do not let this be a one-time thing, but Lord, I pray that this would last, Lord God. For generations to come, we would talk about this night, Lord, here at World Harvest Church Elkhart, Lord. Lord, we love you, Lord. We praise you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you are good to us, Lord, that you are the same yesterday, today, and forever, Lord. The same God that gave David deliverances, you are the same God that gave us deliverance tonight, Lord. We thank you for that. Lord, I pray a blessing over the Oswald family, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for their ministry, Lord. Lord, we pray right now continued healing in Austin in Jesus' name, Lord. Lord, bless their ministry in Jesus' name. And Lord, I thank you for every single person that's in this room, Lord. We thank you for what you've done tonight, Lord. And Lord, as we go out tonight, Lord, I pray that you would use us tomorrow and on Friday and Saturday and bring us back on Sunday. Let us be a light in your dark world, Lord. We claim this place for you. Be with Israel tonight, Lord. Lord, I pray right now that you would stop Hamas in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray right now safety over that nation, Lord. We know they are your people and they are our people, Lord. Your people are our people. And so we pray for Israel right now. Protection over them, Lord. Lord, get those church people from America. Get those back here safely in Jesus' name. Lord, we trust you, Lord. Lord, we pray for every believer that's over there, Lord. Let them, be a light in that dark place right now. And Lord, we ask for revival in Israel, Lord. Lord, what the enemy meant for evil, Lord, we ask that you would turn it around for your good. And Lord, I pray right now for every single marriage in this place, Lord. What you have put together, let nothing divide. Lord, I pray for every parent, every caregiver, Lord, everyone that's raising the next generation, give them wisdom beyond their experience of how to literally lead their home in the ways of you, Lord. And Lord, we ask that you would bring us back safely on Sunday so we get to do this all over again, Lord. We love you. We thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we say amen. Amen. Hey, can we give Valor a thank you for leading us in worship? Pastor Brian, thank you so much. Your invitation is wide open. And can we thank Pastor Parsley for sending Pastor Brian? We want him back as soon as possible. So, man, we love you. Thank you for what you did. Hey, God bless you guys. Have a great rest of your Wednesday night. Don't forget, Sunday morning, cross training, 8:30, service at 10. And then we've got our What's Next class after that. If this is your first time here, fill out one of those Connect cards. Take it to the New Here booth. We love you, and we'll see you guys Sunday.